Right when we started designing a water unit, we had been approached by Jenny Havel of Green School, Albemarle Green Schools, and you know, we decided we want to put together this awesome water week, this whole unit based on water. So we really wanted to figure out a way that the environmental science students could do something special. We brought in Dan Triman with the RIVANNA Conservation Alliance. Dan, you know, we was talking to him about going out and testing the local rivers, and we wanted to develop our own piece of equipment to do that. We didn't want to just do the same tests everybody else is doing. You know, they usually give out little kits, but they're very, but not really true data that they would actually use when analyzing rivers. We wanted to design a piece of equipment that we could get continuous data, really see the changes, the daily changes. You know, we wanted to design a piece of equipment that maybe during a big storm we could see what was running off from local parking lots, local areas, and see what it was doing to our waterways. So we had two student volunteers right off the bat. They were both very excited about it, Becky Spear and Perry Lee. So we started the coding process, building it, and really ran into some, I mean, there was a lot of troubleshooting involved. The idea was to take something that was built just to do one reading at a time and find a way to get continuous readings. So the students really, I mean, we started drawing up ideas, how are we gonna enclose this thing, you know, talk about how deep, how far it has to be above the water, how are we gonna keep it from washing downstream. We came up with anchor ideas. We ended up using a huge piece of PVC attached to a couple smaller pieces of PVC, a lot of silicone caulk, a lot of electrical tape, used shopping bags to help pad it on the inside. But we ended up having something. I mean, we did not foresee it getting hit by a few huge branches out there, but we actually were able to get data. It was on a stormy night, so we got to see several hours of really impressive data. We had, you know, designed the housing, we repurposed the probes, and we actually ended up with accomplishing what we set out to do.
This is so exciting, guys. Right. I'm actually probes. Just really happy.
We're probes doing it first.
This is so exciting. No, I'd rather do the other one, so it's not.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, do we know which one we want where? I mean, it doesn't matter. Oh my goodness gracious. Oh my goodness gracious. Is that like pretty much in? Oh no, do not slide out.
Oh no.
Electrical conductivity.
ECU, so we're probably gonna end up putting the probe that way.
RTD, oh, right?
Yep.
RTD. Okay. Which one's the blue one? The blue one's pH, right? No, it's not.
Yep, pH.
Oh, blue. Sick. Yeah, it's on.
Yep. So lights, we're good.
Do we want to wait to turn it on until we get down there? Doesn't
I think
matter?
We just get this whole thing pretty much.
Let's go.
Yeah, because we can push these up from here.
Yeah.
You know, and just tape them nice. However we want.
Yeah.
Which way are we going?
Right
here.
You do that acid rain activity.
So are we getting it set up in the water first, or are we going to get it set up here and carry it out?
Yeah, I think we should set it up out here.
Somebody's going to
have to. You don't have to,
Oh, it's facing right here. This is not working. This came out of the hole.
We need some tape.
Good.
Yeah, we need.
Okay. How much rain are we supposed to get tonight?
Not much.
Not much?
I don't think so. I think it was like an inch. It's and
thunder,
a half.
Lightning. As soon as she says that.
You can stand here all day.
Not is this, just is this good? Do you want me to carry it with you? Oh my god, Perry!
It really was pretty cool to see them actually taking this piece of equipment they coated, wired, built the housing for, you know, design themselves and actually take it out to really do a test run. And it all worked out perfectly that we actually were doing it on a day where it was going to rain overnight. But I think they just learned that process of taking a really challenging project that was, I think, overwhelming for myself. I'm sure overwhelming for the students, but that we all worked through it together. And I think we all learned something, but I think the biggest thing is that we just look for creative solutions. But yeah, I just hope that we can maybe have a few of these going in the future. Maybe students can build, you know, different models. Maybe it's something that a local conservation alliance might be interested in using. You know, if they keep out in certain hot spots to see if there's changes or places they're concerned, this could be a piece of equipment they could use if we fine-tune this. Maybe it is something that professionals will start using.
Okay.